Do you want to become a pro when coming to use Lightmatica? I do just that in this video and explain some of the key features that distinguish the noobs from the pros. So, I wasn't 100% truthful that you are an expert yet. Because there is one pro thing that I showed you last episode. And that is the normal mode for using Lightmatica. There's also simple mode. Simple mode is identical to normal mode with one exception. You don't have subregions. So it does make some things impossible, but if you're used to the structure block mechanic in vanilla Minecraft, simple mode might be the way for you because you're already used to it. But if you're doing this on yourself, by yourself, without that, I suggest the normal mode because it just allows you to have that higher flexibility. So, last time, when we made this particular schematic, we made multiple subregions. But let's say that I want to no longer be ending this subregion, which is the last one we made, and wanted to edit this one. Well, you can go under Area Editor, and if you click on the one you want, and it'll be highlighted like this one is, it will select that one. Then, if you want to select another one, you can click it. Or if you click again, it'll fully deselect all subregions. If we go to our menu here, you can look at that corner menu and you notice it doesn't say anything about the subregion selected. And so any mouse movement or left right clicks won't do anything. You can then select again and edit as you please. Same thing works for schematics. So I have this new one, and we can just click on it to edit. Or we can go back in, click it on one last time, and we don't do anything. This is a good way to prevent you from accidentally changing your schematic while having a stick in your inventory while in survival mode. I've never run into that, of course. A pro move that you can make in Lightmatica is how to create an area from placement. Now this is used mostly when you have to edit something that someone else has made, and you can use it in conjunction with other features to quickly iterate. Once you have your placement done, you can click the From Placement button in your Area Selection Manager, and give it a name, and we're done. So, there are a couple things you can do in your Area Editor and looking at a specific subregion when it comes to your corner. So you can first select this specific corner, or you can deselect both. When both are deselected and you hold the Alt key, you can move the whole schematic, the whole block, any way you like. And again, if you go in and select just one, it acts like I explained in the last episode. So, let's say that you were trying to make this, but you don't like where it's set in your origin, which is right on this block. Well, let's go into our Area Editor and turn on Manual Origin. This will allow you to select that origin block, and then you can left click wherever you would like it to be. So maybe you put it right in here inside the room, and that way you can just left click wherever you'd like. This is also useful when building symmetrical builds, such as circles, or building something based on a specific location in your existing base. This can be exceedingly helpful when you're combining multiple schematics as well, so I would suggest using it as often as you can. So, there's one last setting that we wanted to discuss today, which is the corner mode. The corners mode allows you to select basically how things are going to act when you're using a stick. So in the corner setting, you're going to select the exact coordinates you want the position 1 or position 2 in. Left clicking select position 1, right clicking select position 2. And so you do have to be very careful because it can hit anywhere. I could right click way out there and it still works. Now, with expand mode, things work a little differently. When you left click, it actually expands the area to include the block that you're clicking. So this means that you can kind of widen the area, but you can't shrink it. To shrink it, you have to right click and now we'll set it to start at the exact position right click on. So if we want to select our entrance again, we select this block by right clicking, and you'll notice there's a very faint outline. And if we left click, we can select the outermost bounds. And that's how you can get that to work. I hope you guys enjoyed these pro tips when it comes to Lightmatica. Go ahead and like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and hopefully we can reach our 200 subscriber goal for this month. But without further ado, this is Naked Light, signing out, and God bless y'all.